the President of the Republic, represented yet by the Honorable of Special Meetings, the Speaker of this Assembly, the President of the General Assembly, Pastor Ijali Tande, the representative of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Vocal Bingham, and other members of this committee. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to be at this historic event focusing on the rights of older persons in Africa. And with the increasing life expectancy, the aging population in Africa is growing steadily. But we still live on no populated rights or privileges, not even in healthcare and social welfare. If we add to this the emerging social dynamics of a new age that is gradually reducing the once strong colonial population and social responsibility among new age youths, we shall observe more communities where an increasing population of elderly are left unattended or in some cases abandoned because the children and immediate family are busy with their own lives or have left their communities for greener pastures. If nothing is done, this community of older people will continue to increase and the situation of the African elderly will look increasingly dire with time. This conference is therefore apt at this point in time as African governments strive for universal health coverage so that the important vulnerable elderly population is not left out of the social safety net. To take up this topic, and in the presence of some high-level personalities today, demonstrate commitment to include older persons in our agenda of prioritizing the health of citizens. This will ensure that they also enjoy social services and quality health care, irrespective of their station and location in the country. Nigeria's aging population of 60 years and above is increasing. In 2009, the National Population Commission estimated that there were 6,987,007 people over 60 years and above in the country, representing 4.98% of the then population. In 2019, the 15 million people over 60 years of age have now grown to 7.5% of today's estimated 200 million population. And this is about the population of some countries. Our commitment to health and social rights for the elderly will be key to changing the game in Africa. Nigeria has endorsed and is committed to achieving goals and targets of the Global Strategic Plan of Action on Health and Aging of 2016 and 2020, and also the 2020-2030 decade of healthy aging, which addresses the sustainable development goals on health and well-being. The Ministry of Health held its National Summit on Healthy Aging December 2018, and formally committed to addressing the question by advocating a conducive social environment for healthy aging and the establishment and implementation of comprehensive health services for the elderly, which IPC project, which is to address the health rights of the aging population. In this connection, the Nigerian government recently launched its national policy framework on healthcare for the aged, titled Healthy Aging. It is presumably the first such policy in sub-Saharan Africa and meant to provide a model for healthcare to geriatric populations in our region. To achieve and sustain it in both rural and urban settings, the policy is integrated into our universal healthcare strategy. We are aware that the output of health spending in Nigeria is 70% of total expenditure, as against the globally recommended figure of not more than 30 or 40%. And also that as of now, less than 5% of our population is covered by health insurance or a risk protection mechanism, as against 90% of the population as recommended by the World Health Organization. The present administration in Nigeria aims for universal health coverage and to alter this unsatisfactory situation with the recent approval by President Buhari of 1% of federal consolidated revenue fund to create this healthcare provision fund as provided for in the National Health Act of 2014 to offer free basic package of healthcare to the poor and vulnerable. This includes the elderly over 60 years of age. Government will continue to improve coverage and quality of care for older persons, broadening access to healthcare services, and the assurance of the right to quality healthcare services will also address the poor health indices in our country. I am hopeful that the elderly will no longer be left unattended in old age due to lack of access to health and social care. Finally, I wish to urge all stakeholders to give adequate attention to the important aspects of social integration, mental health, psychosocial support, and occupational therapy to cater comprehensively